There's a lot happening in our country, but in the meantime, here's another video for you guys.
Yeah, thank you so much for joining again. Today we have again a tech review, and today we're gonna be talking about the Samsung S21.
Sure.
Let's bring it out.
2021
and see.
New things. Let's go.
So here's the phone. Samsung Galaxy S21. 5G. It's a standard these days.
Flagship status, the best that Samsung has to offer.
and I guess let's maybe have a look at it and see like what's inside. Normally there's this and inside the box you just have the phone in itself. Obviously you must have the phone.
You must have a phone. If the box doesn't have a phone, send it back.
That's the one thing that you must have. And then you have this packaging, and then obviously there's nothing else. Normally there used to be a bit more like in the box. It's just so sad and so lonely and so dark.
No, but that's how I know you have a premium phone, man. The less stuff in the box, the better your phone is.
That's still a bit sad. So inside the box, you also have the pin, which is there to help you take out the tray. And then inside the box, there's the instructions. And then you have the cable. I took it out so bad. This is not supposed to be how it's going. And then you have the more manuals and.
I know Senzo reads all the. You read the whole thing this weekend.
Yeah, I think maybe not yet. I still get some time to read it. I think the excitement is more on the phone, like rather than you figure out the other stuff like later on. And yeah, you have just like the cable and no charger, and which is like
sign of a premium device.
Yeah, it's so sad. I miss chargers, man. The chargers, wherever you are, we just know that we do miss you a lot. And the cable is like a USB-C to USB-C. From both sides, which is also a bit of a problem because I guess like the adapter, there's not one that are already out there that have like the USB-C. Normally it's the other normal USB that people normally have. So you must buy that block. Even though if it was here, it would have been nice, but now you must go to the shop and buy it. Okay, then we have the phone. It's a matte black Galaxy S21. It comes like with everything. I think the phone, I think this color does look, it's mostly preferred by most people, and I also like this one. There are other colors, but I think this matte black one is quite popular with like a lot of people.
I think because it looks nice, it looks more premium. I said that word premium so much times. But anyway, it looks very sleek.
I think definitely. You never be disappointed with this color. It's also like quite premium, as Alan says, and the black just blends, especially like when your phone is in dark mode, which is what we currently have at the moment. So yeah, it's a nice appearance, and the cameras have been like very different compared to like the previous cameras that Samsung has had in the S20 and other ones. So I guess let's jump into like the list that we have and we want to run through. So the first thing that we have is like the battery of the phone. So the phone is like 4000 milliamp battery. That's not too bad.
It's like that's good.
Yeah, so I mean you should get like the whole day to last like for the whole day, regardless of what you're doing. It should be able to have like enough battery to run throughout like the day. It's not showing the true reflection because I charged it before we did the video, but I mean you should have enough battery to run through the day. So there shouldn't be like any problems with like the battery that you have. So it's like 4000 milliamp. And then with the other ones like the S21 Ultra, then you get like more. And I think I might be wrong. It's like 4800 for the Plus. And then I'm not sure if it's more for the Ultra.
That's like carrying around a power bank with you. You don't even have that much.
But I think considering like the features that like 5G, if you're in the 5G area, then it will like use up the battery quite big. And then the other stuff with the the rest of the phone.
I mean, I guess one of the next things, it has a sexy display as well, right? Maybe tell us about that.
I think the display is also quite nice. I think like you can never be wrong with the display. Everything is quite crisp. Everything is clear. And I mean, we'll get more to other stuff that are linked to the display. But the display in itself is like quite good. And there's like the 120 refresh rate. So it's like when you're watching stuff and you like must navigate and do that, it's like pretty responsive. You can do a lot of like those without any issues. I mean, this is not the right test. I mean, the right test would be like just loading stuff and then just seeing like the how much it takes to load that. What's nice is that the refresh rate can be the adaptive. So depending on what you're using, the app that needs like higher refresh rate, then it will go up to 120, but if it doesn't need that, then it will just be like the normal rate.
And just for everyone watching, so your refresh rate determines how much times your phone refreshes per second. So it's like 120 times in the second. So
and that's quite a lot. I mean, just thinking like a second is not enough time to be able to refresh that amount of times. So but I guess that's crucial, depending like of how much phones must do. Like now there's much greater expectations in terms of like them. So yeah, and then I guess the next thing is like the storage of the phone. So you get one which is like 128, and then you get like 256 gigabytes. So this one is 256 gigabytes without like a memory card, and that's another thing. No memory card on the phone, which
that's
is
another sign of premium features.
It's sad, Alan. It's sad. Like we miss SD cards, like we miss the fact that you can upgrade your storage to like the one that the phone normally has. So I mean, yeah, it's sad for me. I don't like that. I'm not a fan of that.
Now I think they're just pushing people to cloud, man. That's the thing.
I guess that makes sense, because the companies make more money for you paying like the monthly cloud storage. But then again, like we don't want to pay more money. We already paid for the phone in itself. Like, give us a break. We must now buy the charger. We must buy the earphones, the buds, and you must buy all of that stuff like separately. I think it's tough out there. But I guess the no memory card. It's gonna be sad, like seeing the SD cards like disappear. But yeah, no memory card, and I guess like 256 does sounds like a lot, but up until you have to shoot like videos like in a higher quality, you must download apps and like take pictures, a lot of that storage can be like consumed pretty much fast. So like I mean, you do need it, but I mean, I'll see like how long it takes for me to max it out. But I mean, currently with just like the apps that I use, not a lot of pictures. I'll just double check how much I've used so far. So I mean, yeah, I've already used like 97 gigs at the moment, and that's just like apps. But to be fair, I have backed up a lot of like photos and videos that I had like from the previous one. So, but just when it's just the phone in itself, I had like 27 gigs that was used. They were just with the phone in itself. But so that means I already have like 150.
So you got like another month left of
and then that's it, and then I can't even buy a memory card, which is like sad. So yeah, I guess welcome to the Samsung cloud drive storage. So yeah, I mean, we'll see how it goes. Then the next thing is like
again one of those controversial topics, huh?
Yeah, 5G. So the phone does have like 5G. Even though like for South Africa, I mean, like there's not like a lot of places where you can really use like 5G.
No, but according to various WhatsApp statuses, 5G is everywhere in the country.
And that's how people are getting it.
But this man has a phone that has 5G.
And so far, nothing so far. I'm still safe. So it just shows that you can't get like COVID-19 from like the 5G. That's like a lie. Ellen has like his iPhone, has 5G in the phone, but nothing. Corona yet, and
didn't even cough the whole month.
No. It shows.
I feel like even more healthy. I feel healthy.
5G might be even making people much more healthier, because they are happy with the speed of the internet. But yeah, I think, look, that's not true. You can't get corona from 5G. It's been proven.
Can't cure corona with 5G.
You can't get it. You can't cure it. It's just like normal, like 4G. Like, it was not doing anything. This one is also not doing anything. But yeah, I mean, like, coming from our areas, there's no like 5G in our areas, like in Khayelitsha and the township. There's no like 5G, which is like a disadvantage. It's still being rolled out, so you might get it like in the when you go to like town. But I mean, like, on your normal everyday use, there's like no 5G. I mean, Ellen, you have had 5G for longer, maybe.
Not even on like only MTN. Then I see the 5G option on my phone.
Yeah.
So I think it was only MTN and then Vodacom launched this like a month ago. So I don't know, Telkom.
I've used Telkom. So yeah, Telkom, like nothing so far.
Nothing.
Yeah. But yeah, I guess let's wait and see. Maybe it's like one of those features we'll experience like later on. Like,
but if you know anyone that's in like the Telkom space, just tell them we need them to put 5G on the phones, man. Please.
Please, Telkom. That's the least you can do. Like, yeah, look, but I mean, let's see how long it goes. But like, what do we have next?
Yeah, I mean, Senzo, this is something that I think you appreciate the most, no? Like, you got this amazing camera.
Yeah, I think the camera is like really good. I think the camera, I think it just shows how important like the cameras are. I know Ellen is not a fan, especially like of like the selfie. He's not a fan of that, but like, I think the camera is like really good. Just like
take a photo of us.
Yeah, you can take a photo, a nice selfie, and then we'll include it here in the video. I think it's so good.
It's almost too good. People mustn't see me in real life.
But yeah, the camera is good, and it also likes when you take videos. Let's also try like a video. You can take like the videos like in 8K, and I'm not sure like which. So we'll just move it up like to the like the
This man ultra HD.
Yeah, and then this is the video.
We hope this comes through on the edit because it's like it's just amazing.
Yeah, sometimes the edit doesn't show the true screen of like the phone, but like I think this is like not bad like in terms of like video.
I see all my flows.
Yeah, normally it's like the other ones you are made to feel good because it doesn't expose you, but now you see everything that you never hope like no one sees your insecurities, but now you are able to see. So I think it's like solid, and like you have like the sensors and then two cameras, and then like it also helps like in terms of like the like even taking pictures at night, because I know companies have been trying to improve their night mode and trying to take that. And then you also have like the single take, which will take like a picture like in different like angles, and then you just have like also like a video combined with a different one picture will be like the dark
to get the exposure over one under, etc.
So we'll just also maybe see if we can include that like in the it's supposed to pop up. I think it's still loading the stuff. But yeah, I think that's the nice thing. If you want to take like a video, then a time lapse, and then like a picture, and then like pictures. I think the what it basically does, it uses the different cameras to try and like either zoom in on one and then do something different on the other one. So you end up having like something like this.
So you can like choose which filters you want.
Yeah, which one you want to play around with, like whether it's like the...
This is going to take it in like black and white.
So you see, and that's like, for people that are trying to get like the best, if you're undecided or know on which one, and then you have like short videos.
Also like a video combined with...
So it like take like a video as well as you are taking that. Yeah. So like you decide a time lapse and like a normal video. Like it just
basically all the features that every way a photo could take, and you take it one way and then you can choose.
Yeah, and it's basically for lazy people, because sometimes you don't have time to figure out like all the stuff. Then you can just say single take, and then you just take that, and then it will give you that, and then you can choose from there.
But that's a good feature. That's a feature that I would want to take, because let's say you record something and now it's supposed to have been in the wide angle but you're all the time using a single one and there's people walking, so that will basically take normal and wide. That's amazing. That is like a feature.
No, I think it's a solid feature, and I think you can see the practicality behind it, because sometimes you have features and then you're like, but what's the use of this? And then I think another thing that they've tried is like this blog mode, which they call the doctor view. So you can see it uses the front camera while also like taking a video. So you can have
like a screenshot of that.
Yeah. So you can basically have like you talking like in the camera in the front video and also like the back one, which is like, I mean, not bad. Like, I don't know how to take a screenshot. Here we go.
Yeah.
So I mean, it's all of these things that are becoming more practical, because I think there's a lot of people that are doing vlogs using their phones. So it's a nice, because you're getting towards the way like you don't really need like a camera in order to vlog, and cameras are heavy and this either choose between like that way or you.
Mm.
So you can have both shots, which is like not bad in terms of like what these guys are doing. So yeah, that's it around like camera. And then I think next thing is more around like the audio and like the sound of like the phone. So like again, we're gonna use the same song that we used from one of the guys that we know, Spyro. Hope he's a friend, because sometimes you don't wanna throw that loose and then like
he's a very good acquaintance at the very least.
Yeah, that's like playing it safe. So I think we're just gonna play his song "What a Life." It's a really solid song. Oh,
Ellen, we can cut that out. Okay,
but I think that what the nice thing is there's no audio in there. I think the audio is like rich, man. Like you can hear the bass, you can hear like the.
It's also like stereo, no?
Yeah.
Do you know this is even like audio stereo on this, because you got like the bezel is like gone on top. Yeah, so where did they even put the speaker?
There's nothing to work with, because I think it might be difficult. I think there's like two punch out holes which they are using also here, but that's almost like not enough, because.
I think that might even be like mics almost. I don't know.
Yeah, because it doesn't make a difference. I think the speaker might be under like a camera.
Like, so the sound is like coming through the display, which is.
Yeah, but I think the sound is not bad. I think overall it's like good sound that you can get like on the phone. Like I think if you wanna use it to listen to music, I know a lot of people use earphones, but if you are like
in a crowd, you might be showing people this video that you're watching on your phone.
Yeah, then like you can definitely like use this to listen to like that. So I think we're going towards like the loss. Yeah.
I think this is one of those deciding factors. No? It's like, so you heard that the phone is good.
After all of these things that you're saying, but now you're going to like, the last straw of like everything, which is always like the price. How much does it cost? Like, how much does it cost? Especially like in South Africa, because I think in other countries, South Africa is like a developing country and it's not everyone has like, whatever, we're still trying to get there. So like in other countries where everyone is like sorted and then they can just walk in the store and get like the phone. So, I mean, this phone is like 19,000.
Yeah.
So it's like 19,000. And
do you know what's crazy? I'm thinking, that's not bad. It's a lot, but I was like, okay.
Yeah. But it's still a lot.
It's still
it's not... because I think we're getting to play around with phones that are like expensive, but like it's still a lot. Like
it is a lot. It is a lot.
If you're taking it like on a monthly basis, that's like 1.7 like per month.
That's a lot.
Like a contract.
That's a lot.
But that's like a short-term contract, like with Samsung. There's different contracts that you can take.
Oh, that's the most expensive contract, like 1.7.
Yeah, because like that's like a call.
You must give me a 48 months plan. I'm spending 300 rand a month for
48 months. You can take it like for but after 48 months, you don't even like the phone.
I can do a balloon payment. Trade in.
Yeah, but I think it's expensive. I think it's like, yo, 19K is like a lot of money.
But you should take it 8K, bro. Like, that's like, yeah, you can film the future. Like, yeah, that's, like,
I think it basically goes back to like, what are you using the phone for? Yeah. Like, we do YouTube videos. We're shooting like for YouTube. And like, if you are someone that's going to use that, I think then it's worth it, because at least there's no pressure of like wanting to now buy a camera as well.
Yes.
You can get away with using it to like get that, because some cameras that can shoot 8K and you wanna take videos, that might be,
yeah,
like,
might even be more.
Yeah, more, way more than that. And this is also like a phone that you're using on your everyday use. So I guess that works out. Like, it's not like a bad deal if you're using it that. But I would say buy the phone only like if you like gonna use it like as like part of like your day-to-day life. But otherwise, like, look, get like a cheaper phone, man. Like, you can get like the other A series, and then you can still get like some of the features. But I mean, if you also want to have like a,
I mean, sorry, I just want to say, like, even filming in 8K, man, no one can watch that. Like, it's only you that can that can watch the thing
because
in 8K.
People are already watching videos in like 144 because you're trying to save data, or 240 like max, because you're still mindful of like the data that you're using. Yeah. It might be interesting to ask people like that are watching this video now, like, what's the quality of your YouTube videos that you normally use to watch like the videos? Because I think 8K, like, it really drowns, like, unless if you have unlimited like Wi-Fi.
But even that, like, I don't think my Wi-Fi is fast enough to stream 8K, man.
Yeah, because you start getting like those like blur moments where you like the video is like kicking and buffering.
I mean, I can watch 4K if I'm like by myself or like one or two people.
Oh yeah, but like not on the same network.
Not on the same, and I can only watch it on my phone. I can't like go on my laptop. My laptop doesn't even have the 4K option in the browser.
Yeah.
Safari must fix that also. I'm here by you, just fix that.
Must switch to Chrome, man, and Chrome has that. but I think that's it. I think that's it. Yeah, thank you so much for joining again. It's always fun to have you guys join and watch us. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel, you like this video, and make sure you leave a comment. Tell us what you think, like anything. Let us know what your thoughts are. Are you buying this? Is 19K a lot? Is 8K exciting? Are you excited about not having a charger? Anything, let us know. Let us know what you think about the phone and the video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, we'll see you in the next video.